Oké. Okay. Hoe is de vrede van Aria? On the slides is Arya Stark from Game of Thrones, looking very frightful, frightening. Okay, I'm Rian Rietveld, almost. I'm a senior accessibility consultant at Level, and I'm also a teacher at the Level Academy, where I teach all stuff accessible. The slides are on slideshare.net. Rian Rietveld, and I've got a code pen made for this. That's on codepen.io/Rian Rietveld, because I'm going to give some live demo screen reader stuff. Wish me luck. Okay, in this talk, I'm going to explain what is ARIA, the first rule of ARIA, and if you are like me, I'm a developer and I like examples, copy, paste, tweak. So I've got four examples of how to use ARIA the right way. And after that, I will give you some good resources, so how you can start from there. So what does ARIA mean? WAI-ARIA. That's the official name. And WAI stands for Web Accessibility Initiative. That's a working group from the W3C. And ARIA stands for Accessible Rich Internet Application Suite. So it's actually ARIAS, whatever. And this is the definition. ARIA defines a way to make web content and web applications more accessible to people with disabilities. That's very broad. That's a very broad definition. But what it actually is, it's all about giving feedback. If you are blind, you cannot see the screen. So what's happening on the screen? What happens on a page? What does it mean? How can I interact? But first rule of ARIA. Guess. Don't use ARIA. Okay. Now that sounds very contradictive, but it's not, and I will explain you why. Don't use ARIA to fix meaningless or incorrect HTML. If you say our accessibility is wonderful because we put ARIA on all the things, that's not the right approach. I will give you an example. Hamburger menus. This is a way to do a hamburger menu. About 50% of the developers think that. You have a div, you give it an ID, for example, menu, to put a JavaScript on. You give it a name, menu, and div. It works for you. All the JavaScript is written, and it works with the mouse, and then somebody tells you, oh, but it also has to be accessible, operatable with a keyboard. And you go testing. And div is skipped. A div doesn't get keyword focus. Okay, then you add a tab index is 0. Ah, it gets keyword focus. But the JavaScript isn't fired. And then you throw in a bunch of ARIA. Role is button. ARIA pressed is true or false. And then it actually works. So you have to put all that extra stuff in. But actually, HTML5 has this wonderful element called button. So don't use this. This is wrong. Use a button, because then you get all functionality for free. This is right. Semantics gives you it all for free. Just always go for HTML5 first. Learn HTML5 deeply before you learn ARIA, before you learn JavaScript. Because that's what interacts with your browser. Your browser generates, or that's what interacts with your user, your browser generates the HTML5. All your JavaScript, all your framework, all your PHP, what it does, it generates HTML5. So that must be correct. And that's what interacts with all the devices, and we get more and more devices interacting with your website. If you use good semantic HTML5, then it works. It's all about feedback, area. What happens on a page? What does it mean? How can I interact? Okay, I will give you four examples how to use ARIA in a good way. And the first one is ARIA expanded. Is something open or is something closed? If you can see, you can see that a menu is open or closed. Or if you have an accordion that is open or closed. If you cannot see, it has to be announced to you. And that you do with ARIA expanded. And now there comes the demo. Wish me luck. Okay. Can you see the HTML? Or must I enlarge it? Who cannot see it? It's good enough? But some bit larger. Okay, I have my glasses on, so I can see. Hop, yeah. Better? Yeah? Okay. So you have a button. And the button has the area attribute, area expanded, and it sets to false. Below that, there's a list, and the list is hidden, with the HTML5 hidden. You can use CSS, display none, whatever suits you best. Okay. And this is the JavaScript that belongs to it. You can all do that much better than me. I'm not a JavaScript programmer, but this is the basics. You have the toggle, and you have the list, and you set an onclick, and that listens if the list is open or closed, and it toggles. So, this is how it's done, and now I'll fire command F5.
VoiceOver in Safari, code pen, ARIA.
Window. Frame zero.
Has keyboard focus.
Okay. Who used a screen reader before? Yeah, all 10 up. All ready. Okay. Okay. This is VoiceOver. That's built in the Mac. And you can use it the best with Safari. It's a very simple screen reader, but it's very good for testing. So, if I could focus on the area expanded. Ta-da.
List.
Collapsed button.
So now it announces it's a list, it's a collapsed, and it's a button. So if you interact with the button, something expands.
List.
Expanded button.
If I press it again.
List.
Collapsed button.
So this is very useful if you have, for example, a menu. If someone targets the button and it says expand, and it says collapsed, and you press the button and it's expanded, then the blind user knows, okay, if I tap further, I tap through the menu. If I choose not to open the button, I can tap further, for example, to the content. So it gives extra information of what you can see to someone who cannot see. So, this area expanded. If you want to
list.
Expanded button.
Okay, if I can read from here.
List.
Expanded button.
List four items.
Bullet one, bullet two, bullet three, bullet four, visited link.
Back to home.
So you give the user control about what to read or not. Okay, I'll stop the screen reader.
VoiceOver off.
Okay, back to area expanded. The next one is area live. Tell me what's changing. If you can see, you can see what's changing on a page. But if a page reloads, then you know, okay, something new is coming. But if you have a change without a page reload, for example, if you have search results, and you do a search, and dynamically you show the search results without a reload of the page. If you can see, you see, okay, new search results. But if you cannot see, it has to be announced to you. And that you do with Area Live. So, Area Live. Ta-da. For example, this is very brief. You have a submit button, and if you press it, it says changes saved successfully. You can see that. But a screen reader cannot announce it because it is not in the area live region. So you have to add an area live region. This is the area live. Can you see this? This is the button, submit button, and this is the area live region. It says area live polite. You add that div, and then the screen reader listens if there are changes in that div. And you have two area lives. You have area live polite, then the screen reader waits until you stop interacting. And you have area live assertive, then it's in your face immediately, for example, with severe errors. So how does that sound? I will reload the page. Okay, screen reader.
VoiceOver on Safari, code pen, submit.
Button.
Okay.
Changes saved successfully.
Now, because of the area live, the screen reader announces changes saved successfully. So what should you announce? If there are new search results, don't announce all the new search results, because that's very annoying. You have to give the user control. But what you can do is, for example, there are new search results, or there are 24 new search results, or there are no search results, find another keyword, for example.
So. Edit text.
Aria live equals polite.
Content selected.
VoiceOver off.
Good. Area live. And then in WordPress we have, thankfully, the JavaScript method WP Ali Speak. That's built into Core, and you can use that. In the handbook, the accessibility handbook at WordPress.org, is completely written out how that is done. There is a link in the slides afterwards. I have a demo of that, and I can show you how it works. This is a demo by Sami Kayone. And what he did, there's a filter, and there's cities. You can select a city, and below that he shows, for example, contacts in that city. Okay, now, how does that work?
VoiceOver on Safari, WordPress speaks. Menu.
Tick.
Kuorinka, Helsinki.
Okay, I'll select the contacts in Helsinki.
Helsinki.
Select city.
Pop-up button. Filtering contacts was successful.
Sami chose to have as message, filtering contacts was successful. So you know there are new search results. What you do as message is up to you. You have to say, okay, I will place myself in the position of someone who is blind. What information should I give? You can give other information, like we have three contacts found, but you can also say a filtering contact was successful. That's up to you. So, but that's, I will close the screen.
VoiceOver off.
I will do an inspect of the code. I'll show what happens. And now you have to say if you can read this. This div. Can you read this or must I enlarge it? Can you see this? Yeah? Okay. So what the function does, the function does, it adds two divs on the bottom of your DOM. And it says a div, an area live is polite. And you have a div, area live is assertive. And then with the JavaScript method, you can actually fill that area live with what you want to announce. In this case, it's in the area live polite. It says filtering content was successful. And then because the screen reader listens to both divs, the assertive and the live, if there's a change in one of the divs, the screen reader will announce it. So that's area live. Okay. and WBI speaker. I will give in the resources a link to the handbook, and there's a full explanation on how to do this. Okay, area label and the screen reader text, class. What you hear is what you get. I will give you a short demo and then explain. These are four links. Are they large enough? Yeah? Okay. There is one without an area label. There is one with an area label, edit my awesome post. But beware, there's also one delete label, or delete link with edit my awesome post. And there's the last one that doesn't use area, but it uses CSS. Okay, I will let you hear it.
VoiceOver on Safari, code pen.
Link.
Edit.
No, this is just normal. Edit. But if you cannot see, you maybe don't know what the edit is about. Maybe it's from the content in the layout that you know where the edit is from. But if you don't know that because you cannot see it, it's just an edit. So what you can do is overrule the link text with area label and give it an edit my awesome post, for example.
Link.
Edit my awesome post.
So it still shows as edit. But it announces for a screen reader as edit my awesome post. I will show you the code later. But beware, it overrules completely the link text.
Link.
Edit my awesome post.
See, you see, delete, but it announces something different. And now you can use CSS.
Link. My awesome post edit.
And what do you notice? It's my awesome post edit. It's the other way around. And that's a Safari bug. Okay.
VoiceOver off.
Okay, I'll show you the code. Area label. So, enlarge it. Can everybody see it? Yeah. Okay. The first one is just an A, normal with the href, edit. And the second one, at the A, at the anchor, you add area label is, and then with the text. And it completely overrules. And the last one, area label, edit text, and it overrules the delete. But then there's also the screen reader text class. And with the screen reader text class, this is a CSS. And it looks like this. Then you can hide something from vision, but you can let it announce for a screen reader. You make it very small. You give the height is 1 pixel, and also width is 1 pixel, because if it hasn't got a height, a screen reader doesn't announce it. Margin minus 1 pixel. Position absolute, and that's the reason why Safari mix-ups the order. And you give it a word wrap is normal. And word wrap is normal means if it's Safari sees it's a very small space, like 1 pixel, it's announcing the letters one by one. And if you do word wrap normal, then it announces it as normal words. And this is real life. So this is how the screen reader text look like. You have an edit, and then you have a span with the class screen reader text, and then my awesome post. So this is what is announced, the span, and the edit. And you only see the edit, but my awesome post is also announced. If you use area, a label, or you use the screen reader text class, it's up to you. It's depending on your situation, beware. If you have the position absolute, Safari mixes them up. It first says my awesome post and then edit. It's very annoying. The screen readers are not perfect. So that's the area label. And then the last example, area described by and area labeled by. How do I fill out this form? Oh, the demo, yeah. Okay. If you have, for example, I'll blow it up. a form with a name and an input field, and you have some extra information below that. That's very common. Like, please give your first and last name. You want to add some extra information. You want to give the user to fill out the form. But if you have a screen reader, you tap from focusable element to focusable element in the form. And then the extra information isn't announced. So they miss on vital information. How do you solve that? There are two different ways to solve that. With area labeled by, that replaces the label text. An area described by that add content to another element. For example, you can add that to your input field. I will let it read.
Voice
name edit text.
Okay, let's start here.
Ta-da. D.
Yep. Selected.
Okay. Ta-da.
Please give your first and name.
Edit text.
Okay. Name, edit text. This is just normal. And the text below is not announced.
Please give your first and last name.
Edit text.
So now is the label replaced by please give your first and last name. And the last one, area described by
name.
Edit text.
Please give your first and last name.
Then it announces the label and it waits a bit and then announces the area described by. And how is that done?
Voiceover off.
Ta-da. So this is the first one. You have a label and a name, an input field. And we all know now, and everybody does this from now, if you have an input field, you also have to have a label. And the label is connected to the input field by the ID van the input field. So you have an input field with an ID that's unique for the page, and a label with a for referring to the ID. That's the correct way to do it, because then it's announced properly. Okay, then you use label by. The text you have, you want to announce with the label, you give an ID. You give it an ID, description one in this case. And then with the label, you say area labeled by, and you refer to that ID. The same, it works the same with area described by. You have a P with an ID, in this case description 2. And here in the input field, you add area described by, and then you add the ID from the message you want to announce. So there's two different ways you can do that. I will show you how it works again with the screen reader.
Voiceover on Safari, code pen, aria, name.
Edit text.
Without.
Please give your first and last name.
Edit text.
Now it's replacing the label.
Name.
Edit text.
Please give your first and last name.
Now it's announced with the input field.
Voiceover off.
Okay. Four examples. So this is to give extra information to people who cannot see. What's happening on a page? This is not to repair and to fix broken HTML5. Okay, I have resources. These are the specs, WAI Area Authoring Practices. They are rewriting the specs, and this is very good news because the specs were actually unreadable. But now they are giving examples, good practice, and more better text. So I'm really proud of that. They're really doing a good job, the WCAG and the W3C. So if you were burned out on the specs, I think this I cannot handle, please go back. And they really improved them. Then, accessibility team has done a lot of work to give good resources on the accessibility handbook on makewordpress.org, and we've got examples of area of good HTML5 about the CSS class, and there's also good documentation about the WLESpeak method. In the slides there are links to these pages, and then there is inclusive components. by Hayden Pickering. And Hayden is has done a lot of research with different screen readers, with different browsers, on how to make inclusive components, like how to do a tooltip, how to do a carousel, how to do a slider, how to do a to-do list. It's a book and a website. I would really recommend it. He is using HTML5 and CSS3 and adds ARIA to that. So if you want good examples, buy that book. And there's the DQ University. They have a website with free online ARIA widgets and code examples. So read that. Take advantage of that, because they also do excellent research. And if you want to study further, Mike Gifford has a GitHub repository with all kind of courses, free, paid, online, in-house. There's a wealth of different courses you can take. So if you want to study further, this is a good point to start. So I want to end my talk with a quote. Make it work before you make it nice. Thank you. Questions?
Do we have the mics?
That's the mics, I don't know.
I had so many questions, but a few that came on mind was, just a couple I'm going to ask you. Are all screen reader texts in English? Does anyone work to translate those?
You have to translate them. And there's in the handbooks is a method on how to localize them.
Okay.
Because it's text. So the text must be also in the language you offer.
And my other question is, are screen readers the browsers of 5 years ago? Like, are they all different? It seems like every time we try to solve some issue, it'll work in two of the screen readers, but not in the other one.
Yes.
And how do you solve that problem as it?
No, not really. Actually now we'll be, I'm sorry. He's asking, are screen readers just like browsers from the past? Like they're all different? Yes, they are. So I actually choose a few to test with and disregard the rest. NVDA for Windows, JAWS for Windows, and VoiceOver for the Mac. And now you have a new one, a Narrator for Edge, that can do a little bit stuff. It's not so sophisticated. But all the rest I just disregard, because it's not doable otherwise. You have to make it, and also you have to, VoiceOver, you have to test with Safari, because in Firefox, VoiceOver announces nothing. And JAWS you have to do with, I think, Internet Explorer 11, I'm not sure about that. But yeah, you have to pick the right browser also with the right screen reader. And that's making life not very more difficult, yeah. Sorry, yeah. Can't give an easy answer on that, yeah.
I have a question over here.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you. Do you have any suggestions on convincing a larger company to invest in ARIA and more accessibility on the websites?
Oh, there are Google is deaf and blind. And there's everything you do for SEO, for accessibility is good for SEO, because Google can index your page much better if it's accessible. There's a legal consequence. If you don't make your website accessible, there are legal consequences, especially here in the US. On the website from the W3C, there is an excellent article about that, about a case, business case for your accessibility. I will share it on Twitter. Yeah, but there are various reasons. Yeah.
Hi. I have a plugin that has a user interface where there are controls in a sidebar, and manipulating those controls updates the content in the main body of the page.
Yeah.
How can we let users with screen readers know that content has changed, and how to, I guess, jump from those controls to the content to see, or to hear, rather, that changed content.
Well, if you give the controls a good heading, so that that's really easy to jump to a heading, and then you announce when you change something in the controls that there's something changing in the results, just new results found or the filter. I don't know what it is.
But
exactly.
Do you need to have a way to jump to the content after it is changed?
No, but in the area live, you just change, you say what is changed, but if there are headings or focusable elements, they can switch between that. If you refer to area control, that you can link stuff together, hardly no screen reader supports that. So area controls is not really something to use. But people navigate with links and with headings, so if both have a good heading, they can jump from heading to heading.
Got it.
Is that a good answer?
Yes, thank you.
Yeah, okay.
Is there any penalty or conflict for using area hidden on items that you're remaining visible?
Area hidden hides from a screen reader.
But and is there any penalty to that, even if you're remaining it visible to the seeing public?
Well, if you... decide a screen reader user doesn't need to know what's there, you can hide it with area hidden, but the penalty is like, you mean legal penalty or?
No, I mean just like, is Google going to penalize you saying, why are you taking this whole text? You're showing it to these people, but you're saying these
Google
people don't need it.
Google doesn't know area.
Okay.
Yeah. Yet.
Yeah. Thank you.
I don't know. I'm not an SEO expert, actually, so I can't answer that. Yeah.
Hello. Thank you for the wonderful session.
Thank you.
When coding hyperlinks, should I no longer be using the title attribute?
Yeah, title attributes should die. Yes. Because you only give the information about the title attribute to someone on a desktop with a mouse. And someone on the tablet doesn't have it, and screen reader users are not consistent of announcing area of title attributes. Some do, some don't. Some replace the text with it, some announce it double. So if you have a consistent experience, use an accessible tooltip, for example, or an area label if you want to replace it and make it more clear for a screen reader user.
Is that as easy as, if I've been using title tags, doing a global search for place and changing title to something else?
Well, title attribute, if it's an additional to the link text, it may be, sometimes it's just additional or some new information, or it depends on how it's constructed in your case. You can use area label to completely overrule it and give all the information in the link text and keep the visual link text the same. But if you have, or you can have an accessible tooltip instead of a title attribute. And if in Hayden's book, from Hayden Picker, Inclusive Components, there are examples of accessible tooltips.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, yeah.
Hi, are there any methods for delivering the ARIA code in the HTML only to screen readers as opposed to everyone?
Sorry, I don't understand.
So if you're outputting the HTML with all the ARIA labels and code, I mean, only the screen readers can use that.
Yeah.
Is there a way to deliver the HTML?
Well, you can use maybe CSS to expose. I don't know, actually.
No, what I'm saying is like a sighted, you know, a person who can see has no use for ARIA.
No.
So why is the code being delivered to them in the HTML? Is there a way to split it so that sighted users get non-ARIA HTML?
And why would you split it? To make your code cleaner?
Make your code cleaner, lighter pages?
Well, I think
code.
You have to offer the DOM to everyone. It's not like you have to have, this site is for blind people, this is for normal people. Like, this is very insulting, I think. I think you need to code
you're,
properly.
So you're saying that's not a suggested method?
No, I think you have one DOM and you offer every functionality to everyone. So, and some people can see and use a screen reader, so they have also the extra information. So it's not like one user, one blind user. There are more people having advantage of that. So I would suggest one DOM.
Okay.
It's also easier maintainable, I think. Yeah, that were the questions. Thank you.